Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to yet another update on the coronavirus. Today's update, I'll be giving an update on the coronavirus in Horry County, South Carolina, the state of South Carolina, the United States, a global update, and also, once again, I'll go over the symptoms, what to do if you are sick, and the ways you can protect yourself. So let's get right into this, shall we? So as far as Horry County goes, there has been 190 confirmed cases. Unfortunately, I'm not sure how many people have recovered, but I bet that there has been a few people that have been confirmed with the virus and that have recovered. So I'm pretty sure that is, but I'm just once again, I'm not sure how many people have recovered from this virus, but unfortunately 12 people have died. Now, as far as the state of South Carolina goes, there has been 4,608 confirmed cases. On the bright side, 67% of those cases have been recovered, so that is a very good thing, and there has been 135 deaths confirmed in the state of South Carolina because of the virus. Now, as far as the United States goes, there has been 891,000 confirmed cases. As far as the amount of people that have recovered, there has been 82,846 people that have recovered, and there has been 50,399 deaths. So thankfully, there's around 30,000 more people that have recovered than have died. Now, don't let this number I'm about to share with you for the worldwide scare you, okay? So right now, there is 2.74 million confirmed cases. Now, get this, I'm going to tell you how many people have died so far. So right now, there has been 192,000 deaths, but listen to this. As far as the number of people that have recovered, there has been 752,000 people that have recovered. So yes, there is a good amount of deaths, but if you set weights on a balance and you go and you put the amount of people that have died from this virus and also the amount of people that have recovered, the amount of people that have recovered is going to outweigh the amount of people that have died tremendously. So yes, there are a good amount of people that have died, but there has been a tremendous amount of people that have recovered. So that is a very good sign that more people are starting now to recover than unfortunately are passing away. Now, once again, for the symptoms, you need to be watching out for a fever, cough and shortness of breath. I get a lot of headaches sometimes, and I'm checking my temperature every single time I get a headache. So, once again, a headache is a symptom of a fever, and a fever is a symptom of coronavirus. So, definitely, every time you're getting a headache from here on out until we get this virus under control, please be taking your temperature and making sure that you don't have a fever. Because if you do have a fever, that's not a good sign that you might have the virus. Once again, also fever, cough, and shortness of breath are the three symptoms. As far as protecting yourself, I know I've said this a lot, but here are the ways you can protect yourself. Once again, please stay at home as much as you can. During these times, if you have to go grocery shopping, be sure that you're wearing gloves and a face mask. Try and avoid frequently touched surfaces like the shelves. Try and only touch the products that you're buying and not the actual shelf. And what I'm doing is that every time my parents go grocery shopping, they are disinfecting and they're dumping out the bags instead of pulling the stuff out of the bags. So I would definitely recommend that you try and dump out the bags instead of grabbing the products with your hands and pulling them out of the bag, because you never know. I mean, those bags come from several different places around the world, and you never know what they have them. So just be on the safe side. I would recommend dumping out your stuff in a safe place rather than moving them out of the bag by your hands. Make sure that you're keeping a safe distance from people, at least 6 feet apart. If you do have to talk, just make sure that you're at least 6 feet apart, distance away from whoever you're talking to. Make sure that you're washing your hands very often for at least 20 seconds. Every time you do it, whenever you come home from somewhere, whether it's the grocery store, whether getting food or essential needs or the pharmacy or whatever, be sure that you're washing your hands the second you walk in the house for at least 20 seconds. Sing happy birthday if you need to. Just do something that will make sure that you know that you're washing your hands. Making sure that you're using a lot of soap. You're getting in between your fingertips. All these tips will be very good tips in keeping you and your family members safe. Once again, if you are coughing or have a cold, be sure that you're coughing or sneezing into your elbow, or just trying and, you know, just try and, you know, stop those germs from spreading, you know, either into the out, either into the air or just away from yourself. So just try, once again, you know, if you have to cough or sneeze, just do it into your elbow. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is the end of my video. I will be doing several more videos for the days to come on more updates on the coronavirus. I try and do an update on the coronavirus in South Carolina, the globe, and the country every 1 to 2 days. I will be doing another update this weekend about I probably will actually be doing another update, another video tonight on the forecast for this weekend. And also this weekend, be sure to stay tuned because I probably will be doing another forecast on the forecast for next week. So once again, as I always say, please stay tuned to my YouTube channel for the latest information on the coronavirus and also the current weather that we're having. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.